Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Church, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I want to appreciate God this morning for my life, for what God has done in my life. I have a long testimony. If I continue to say it today, I don't think we will leave this place. But I will cut it short. Most I want to thank my daddy here is my daddy. Daddy, I don't know how to thank you for what God has been using you to do in my life. I say, may the Lord continue to bless you and your family in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I don't know many of you are here when I was brought nothing. I took the result to the doctor. Immediately, they admit me. I say, I did not inform my mom. I did not inform my parents, so I need to go home. Then when I get home, it was not, I don't know where I am. So I told my parents immediately, they look for money. That's the same day I was admitted. I spent 10 days in the hospital. The enemy was fighting me. Even in me, the day of my grandmother's burial, Saturday, that is when I will say I was dead. Because I don't even know when they fix me hostage. I was not breathing again. But I thank God that day, the burial I came for, the enemy did not allow me to attend the burial. So I thank God that day, the Lord brought me back to life. That is when I know that they fix me hostage. I say, God, I thank you. And the hospital, the bill is too much. So they discharged me. So my parents went to look for money. So, and that I was still in the hospital. I said, 2 o'clock in the night, I said, let me ease myself. So my uncle came and his wife to visit me in the hospital. The money they gave to me, immediately I touched that money, my hand wanted to paralyze. Because my Bible always with me, even when I was in the hospital, I always read my Bible. So immediately I see sign in my hand, I put the money in my Bible, I say, devil, you are a liar. Then, that the same day they came to visit me, 2 o'clock, I eased myself. In the only time I could see, I was doing like man person. All the whole thing, the hospital, I scatter everything. All the patient there was crying, what is this? We are okay. So that day my dad said I must be discharged. As I came home. When I came home, the enemy did not stop there. I started to cough. When they called one man, they said they have thrown me in tagba. I could not lie down with my two sides. On my ribs, if I'm coughing today, it will be shot. I don't even have strength. So immediately, upon the mercy they applied to me, it could not work. Then that is the day they brought me to this place, on Sunday of feet. So after that, they prayed for me, we closed. The enemy did not stop there. Then my mom now took me to their place. They now sent conversion to me. I was covered. I said, God, I am tired. I want to go. God, come and take my life. On that place, daddy did not leave me. I said, God, I am tired. No problem the other. I don't have the strength again. God, take my life. I want to go and rest. So that is how the man still said, the man that is giving me medicine, he says, still have the medicine. On Thursday morning, I was brought here Thursday morning last week. Early in the morning, I was brought here. On Wednesday, I said, let me check my clothes and my children's clothes. For there, I don't know, madness entered me on Wednesday morning. I was scattering everything. Nobody would talk to me in that house. That's how I was talking what I was saying, what I was supposed to say. So on Thursday morning, daddy, my mom and my auntie, they brought me here. And daddy prayed that God used our daddy here to pray for me. And that madness go. So from that
moment,
God has been so good to me. What I'm experiencing before, God has taken it away from me. Praise the Lord! God has done it. His name alone continue to be exalted forever in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Church, pray!
Thank you so much, our Father. You never leave me. Even though I'm not here, you never leave me. You still continue to reach my family. Anytime when I call this our Father, Daddy, you are my spiritual father. You are my father in the Lord. You not make me call, but you never tell me bring one naira. Daddy, may your day be loved. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Grandma, last Sunday. Last December Sunday. Eh? You see what happened. And after that one, you see when it was scattered, I was there. I said, this is my daughter. Even though that day, this first day before they brought her, one boy was brought here. What happened? They say he went to go and eat something and madness come. Immediately, I touched with Mato. It's Mato I used to pray for her. Praise the Lord. Just touched the Mato. What happened? That one go before they brought her. And what happened? I used Mato to pray for her again. What happened? Disappear. As the grace you are under, no enemy can be able to attack you. Amen.